Hi all. Right, so the main, or should be the largest single part of this particular side pod mold, has now got the required 8 layers that I wanted. Need to be 2 to 3 times of what the actual body part thickness is. I normally do sort of roughly 3 layers of 300 gram in this, so I'm about 3 times that now. Like 8 layers, so but 4 of the layers were 450 grams, so it's heavy. You can probably see by the thickness here, we're kind of like, you know, 3/8 of an inch thick, so that's way thicker than we make the actual part. So, yes, anyway, so that's the first stage, which we did on the hobby horse. But now we need to make the extra stages, so. Basically, there'll be a partition we're going to have to build here. And again, out of good old corrugated plastic, so we'll build a partition here, so then that'll make one section for this end. We'll build another partition off of here, so that end there will be one section. And then we'll have another partition, we'll have another section here that will join that end, do this top surface, obviously come up here and join to here as well. So. Yeah, we still have some work to do. So we've got 1, 2, 3. Obviously, they're a lot smaller sections, so it's a lot easier to do them. And plus, we have the one annoying surface, which is what this weird triangle section is here. That surface that's underneath there, which unfortunately was a negative release angle. So we've had to do a section there that'll be the first thing we'll pull out when you've done a part. You have to pull that section out first to basically get rid of the angle that's sort of coming up and therefore would cause a lock and you wouldn't be able to remove the part from the tooling. So there'll be 5 sections to this mold in total. And that's just really the first mold. But yes, everything seems to have worked out pretty well. Didn't have too much bleed through with the gel coat underneath here. Had a little bit sort of here, you can just see it's come through, so we just knife edged that down and then just took it off. So you can still see there's a little bit of black there. We need just to get that off and then we'll and then we'll polish. Now this has already been polished eight times. So we don't need this so much, but we do need the partition now. I've wiped the PVA off it, which was from the which is what I put on top of the sprayed on top of the corrugated plastic, but we now need to basically wax this 8 or 9 times, and then once the wax has gone off, we'll put a couple of layers of wax here as well, because it seems rude not to. Once that's been waxed up, then we'll spray PVA this section again. That's after I've built the two partitions, but partitions and this is the easy, nice and easy. It's just one square bit there and one square bit there. Then we'll build the large section in the center, because it's nice and horizontal. And unfortunately, because I've got to build this mold from the underneath here, like I said before, it's hard to, you can't really get a fiberglass on the bottom of anything. It just, gravity just wants to hold it off. So we'll do the top section first. Once that's done, we'll turn this back on its side. Then we'll be able to do one end section and then the other end section. Much for annoyance, I can't really do anything along here and can't really do the little pokey ones go around the corner until basically the two ends are done. So it's kind of slow and laborious and there's not much we can do about it, but it has to be done. So we did have a little bleed through where we built the mold registration marks. And we just built them purely out of the yellow mold release clay. I can't think what we call it exactly, but there was a little bleed through underneath the clay, so I've just hammered the little stuff out and then just filed around the edges there. Yet again, we don't want anything getting behind there and producing a lock, which actually I can feel a bit more. Yeah, there's a shelf there, so I need to file a bit more off of that. So there isn't a lock, so it should come out. The mold will have to come out in a specific order. Probably first section to come off will more than likely be this end. Yet again, we've got to make sure we don't lock things in. That angle there is about the same as the angle it's in here. I've got to file this out a little bit because that angle's not quite so same as that, so we don't want to get lock again. It's only a small amount. Once it comes out, then split, it should come apart pretty easily. We just want to make sure we don't create any lock. I'd hate to make a part and find I can't get the part out of the mold. That would be really kind of annoying. So yes, while I'm waxing up this, then I can start partitioning the next side. So side pod 2.0, we'll start doing that and getting that ready. Yes, you can see a reasonably large amount of mess, but at least most of the mess is on the plastic, not on my concrete floor. So yes, there we go. Feeling a little more confident now. We have two layers of the vinyl ester gel coat put on this mold. First time I put one layer on top of another layer and had a lot more success with it not reacting. You can tiny see a little bit of reacting there, but we had to waste a little bit that way. But basically, as I mix the gel coat up, as I mix the gel coat up in a cup, I think what I've previously done is I've used a brush or whatever else in here, and I've basically managed to remove some of the gel coat that wasn't quite mixed properly with the with the Merc, and basically that stuff wouldn't go off properly. So what I've done is I've mixed it up in one pot, and once I've mixed that up in the one pot, then I'll pour it out into a more horizontal tray. So when you pour it out, hopefully any of the stuff that's stuck to the sides, like it has in these two, that stuff there will be the stuff that doesn't go off properly. Once you put it to second pot, then realistically, there's more chance what you've mixed up has got the correct Merc catalyst in it, and it goes off better. Because when it's not gone off properly, you put the second layer, or you put the first layer of fiberglass on top, then it all crinkles up, and basically, and that's purely to the fact the first layer wasn't quite mixed with the Merc. So, and second tip, if you didn't already realize, you can see how this is distorted on the side here, because I've just been dumping my extra resin that I didn't need in here. The thicker or the deeper, the more dense the mixture is in there, the faster it'll go off. So if you pour it out onto a larger surface area, so therefore the it can only be 2 inches deep instead of, what, 6 inches deep. How do we say that? It gets rid of the heat, albeit the heat, maybe the slightly wrong word. It gets rid of any heat that's starting to build up on it. And it's when the heat builds up that it goes off. The Merc catalyst basically creates it to go off. So if you can put the gel coat in a flatter area, like you put it onto there, it will go off a lot slower because it's only 50 mil thick, or 50 thou thick to avails. Only 50 thou thick, it takes a lot longer to go off. If you leave it in the pot, it gets really, really hot, has a high exotherm, it goes off a lot faster. So you can put it in a tray. Some people even do put it in a tray. While you're spreading it on, the tray will not start to gel. It will give you a longer gel time than it would do if you left it in a pot. Not as quite so critical, I suppose, because you are putting this down pretty quick, so you're not mucking around. But larger surface area, more heat dispersion, more gel time, so which is a good thing. Anyway, yes, I'm rabbiting on. Time to do some more polishing. Speak to you all soon.